or daily videos.
You're going to f***ing jail. Oh my. God. Look at this guy. Look at this guy. He just I did not. Dude, look at this piece of shit. Dude, look what he did in my car. Look at this piece of shit. Look at you. Are you gonna attack me? Are you gonna attack me? What did I do to you? What are you, nuts? What did I do to you? What did I do to you? This is the guy's plate number. Are you embarrassed to this guy? He just destroyed my brand new car. He just destroyed my brand new car, you idiot.
I'm taking a video.
F*** you up your ass. If
why?
You call the police on me, I'm going to sue you.
Why?
I asked you to call me a f***ing ambulance.
Why?
Because I lost my ID and she won't let my hotel pay her with a credit card.
So why do you need an ambulance?
I need an ambulance because I'm manic. I haven't slept in 7 days.
What? What do you mean do you need an ambulance for a hotel key? People, they getting weirder and weirder, man.
7 days, I have a concussion, I have a backache, I have a bump on the back of my head.
Why haven't you slept in 7 days?
Because I'm manic.
What does that mean?
I can't explain to you.
Okay.
Lying.
And if you put anything recording to me,
I'm allowed to, actually.
No, you're not
legally,
allowed
I
to.
Am.
Legally, you're not.
I am.
Legally, you're not.
Well,
not without
to.
My permission.
Well, I'm going to.
Well, do what the f*** you do, but my lawyer will sue the f***ing shit out of you,
okay.
Dumb.
Okay.
Copyright infringement?
Alexa.
Alexa what?
Jennifer.
Jennifer is your last name?
Yeah, I have two first names.
Alexa Jennifer.
Uh-huh.
You're going to jail.
Yay, can't wait.
Yay for you, you can get f***ed in your ass.
Okay.
Can you my drink, please?
I need you a drink. What? You need to step out.
What a shame.
Oh my god.
Do you think it's funny,
Stuart? I do think it's funny.
You are going to hell.
Me too.
And you are the devil. There is nothing funny about it.
Okay. Thank you.
Why don't you come in here so I can beat the shit out of you?
Alright.
Come on.
I will.
Come on.
Alright, I'm right here.
Let's get off the property.
Run hands, shawty, run hands.
Run hands, shawty.
Come on.
Oh, no, son. Stop this. Where are you from? Where is the cameraman from? She gonna say something. Run hands, shawty. She sound like.
The property.
I'm good. My
they
car's right
the
here.
They called the police.
They're calling the police?
Yes, come on, you scared little. I'm not.
Jesse, can you step away, please?
I will break your skinny
neck.
Aww.
Aww. You're so sweet.
Thank
you. Aww.
Are
do you have a dick?
Meth?
What?
Both, actually.
Eat something, skinny bony.
I work out a lot. Sorry.
He just
I have
you.
No fear of
he
a person
just,
like you.
I have no fear of you either.
You better have fear.
I
you
have
don't
no
know
fear at
I
all.
Am.
I have no fear at all. So what do you want me to fear? What do you want me to fear? You want me to fear something?
The police.
So, okay, call the police. We're not doing anything wrong. I have him standing in the middle of the road. All you have to do is beat the horn or lower
I
the window
smell ganja.
And tell him to.
The police
there's
are coming.
No, I have no ganja here, so you can go ahead and do something. Go ahead. Call the police. I have no ganja here. Are you going to go on with your day or are you going to keep standing
here? I'm going to go on my day as long as I know my children are here and I have a person like you around.
We'll see about this.
Damn right.
I'm standing right here. I'm standing right here.
Do you know what I expect?
What do you expect?
I expect when there's trouble in the community that someone like my neighbor would come along and help me out.
Okay.
Not the yelling in the middle of the street about things aren't appropriate.
You just came up to...
You're not reading me.
Pa, so I'm here working on my garage, and we're not doing anything wrong, and one of my friends is standing in the street. This guy drives up right behind me. Yo, go in my house and go and get my wallet. They're going to need my ID. Go and get my wallet. Yeah, this guy comes. He's sitting right in front of me. He won't move. He comes and he drives up, and my friend is standing in the middle of the street, and then he moves out of his way, and he comes up.
I'm not kidding.
He's like,
around.
Oh, you're not... You're what are you? What
because
are you stupid
the smirk
doing?
Means that you'll never help somebody
just,
in need.
Keeps, like,
you're a troublemaker.
He's just standing here screaming at us.
No, I can read people well. You're not a good human being.
Oh my God.
Okay, I'm gonna call the cops. Yo, are you recording everything?
Yeah.
Smile and laugh, my
I'm
friend.
Gonna call the police.
My life is 300 years of life.
He just right here in the truck.
My wisdom is out your nose.
I haven't done anything wrong.
What?
Should I call the police? But yes. Then I have to call my probation officer.
There you go, probation officer. What the heck is wrong with you, boy? Yeah. I'm not afraid of you. I work at the prisons for a living. You have no clue who I am. I'm not afraid of you. I'm the real thing. That's your fear factor. I'm the real thing, guy. I got enough clearances up my nose to handle you.
I'm just asking what
please
is
call
this?
The law.
Please do.
I know, please. You people are ignorant.
You people.
Your reservation is not in my system.
Ma'am,
one. We extended
ma'am,
a courtesy to you, which we did not have to.
Ma'am.
Step away from my counter.
Whoa, this is so unnecessary.
You people are unnecessary. And call Catherine, too, the state trooper, please.
Please.
Ignorance. What is funny?
I've never seen somebody
I know,
go from 0 to 10 when, like I said, I came here.
Completely calm.
My sister was just talking. I know.
You
which is ridiculous.
You should have come up and handled your business instead of sending someone saying you were corporate.
So I can apologize to you and tell you that, yes,
I
should.
I need you to step away from my counter.
You're not being logical right now.
I have no intention to be. Do you understand?
She's an honored member. She's a loyal customer.
Great.
And
I know
not,
my authority too, please and thank you.
That's fine,
wow,
but
this is,
there's no try to customer service. I mean, we're not yelling at you.
I'm going to ask you to get your belongings.
We're not yelling at you. It's not even checkout time.
Yet.
I know. We still have an hour.
I suggest you get your things.
We still have an hour.
Well,
so please don't. Yeah, so please do not
and
enter that room.
And please don't come back to my property, and I'm going to flag you guys too. So just keep running your mouth. You're not hurting guys but yourself.
But what are we saying, though? We're not yelling, we're not escalating our voices,
true.
We're not standing on any counters, trying to be very respectful. No one said we wouldn't leave.
No, they want special treatment, so I think they deserve it. 4906 Timber Drive, Lake Park. I'm at your property today.
We haven't even tried to figure out what exactly happened. Dumb. I've never been treated like this in my life. Anybody. The sad thing is, I feel like I almost feel like it's a racial thing.
I do.
But I don't know how. Yeah.
Boom.
I don't know how we got
there. There you go.
That's all I was asking for. So I was like, please calm down. I wanted to talk about it.
Right. There momentarily.
I hope you do take this corporate. I mean, I'm going to use this as an internal thing when I fly back to Miami. I cannot wait.
Oh,
and ignorance is when.
Oh.
your business, you should have sent someone besides your sister if it's on your card. Secondly, I am the GM. I'm telling you internally, I checked. Your reservation was canceled by a third party, which is not on our end, nor is anyone in the system. One of you, whoever booked it, which she said she didn't know, which would fall on whomever that might be, would be one of you. So how is our hotel at your fault? There's nowhere else to put you. You're lucky you got in a room for what we did do for what my girl had last night. She contacted me, and I did check internally last night. But ignorance is bliss, and you guys are just blazing this morning. And then to ask for a cop escort out of a hotel when someone tells you you're not welcome?
No, we did not.
No, they both have your names, and so what do you think should happen? You think you should stand up here to place the business and call and complain and handle your thoughts? Right there's the business office. If you have corporate complaints, walk yourself right in there and call. I'm not afraid. I don't know what you people think.
Well, first of all, Miss Rose,
I do not want to talk to you. I'm not going to argue with a fool. Do you understand?
Wow.
A fool?
Oh, God, shut up.
Oh, man.
Ebony.
You know that's a fresh.
Stop.
Yes.
So, I don't want to talk to you. I'm not going to argue with a fool. I'm just not.
So we're both asking questions. I know you ask questions. Are we going to have a conversation? Or do you just get to talk?
I'm done. Do you understand? The law is coming. You've got an hour to get your belongings and leave my property. Do you understand? Can I make myself any more clear? Discussions went out the window an hour ago, and it took you 20 minutes to tell what the actual problem was when there isn't one.
It hasn't even been an hour. No, I wasn't trying to get a free room.
I didn't say that either. I did not say that at one time.
No one behind this desk cares at this point. So if I were you guys, I'd get my stuff and I'd leave. If you're being so polite and kind now at this point.
We have been from the beginning.
Sure.
Ms. Crystal, have I ever at once
raised
my voice?
She's too ignorant to answer your question, remember?
Nobody called anybody ignorant.
Oh,
you
incompetent.
Did.
I think that was the word.
No.
She said that you called.
Look at that body language.
I did not. Not at one time did I say that.
The young lady was very nice to us last night.
And I said that too. I said she did the best she could.
She was very nice to us last night, and we appreciated it. She said that there were a lot of issues. That's what she told us. She said there were a lot of issues, and she was trying her best to try to take care of it, and she did accommodate us. And we appreciated the fact that she accommodated us. And you're right. I should have been the one to come and talk to you. She just wanted to handle it because she does work with Hilton, so she wanted to just have me have the best experience possible. So I wasn't asking for a refund. I was asking, like she had told us, last night, she said, you'll want to come downstairs and ask for the room that I had actually reserved, which was a 2-queen room. So that's what we were attempting to do, was just be able to move to our queen room like I booked weeks ago through the Hilton app. And so, and I had even checked into my room already.
Logies.
I checked into room 207, was the room that I had requested. And then when we get here, we find out that it was canceled. So to our surprise, our room was canceled. So no one knew that it was canceled until we got here. So all we were trying to do was try to make sure, figure out what was the issue. And every other hotel I've gone to, we're able to talk through it and get accommodated. Just not even
hotels.
No,
you
ma'am.
Want to talk through issues?
Yes, ma'am.
We are not welcome in our hotel again, ever.
And I understand that, and that's unfortunate.
Yeah. I already seen that.
And I understand that, and that's unfortunate. This is the one I chose because this is nearest to my grandmother's house, because we came here for an event.
Again, I do not care.
For my grandmother. So
We asked
for someone to be able to mediate this conversation.
There's
is all
nothing
we asked
to
for.
Mediate. You don't have a reservation. We accommodated you to help. I asked you to check out. It's at 11. Miss Laura, if you need to move your things in the hall, we can do that too, or you're welcome to get your things on your own.
Miss Laura, we don't check out, but we don't check out. Checkout's not till 11 because now you're taking it to another level.
So you want to argue?
You're taking
what?
It to another. Nobody wants to argue with you.
Oh my God.
We want you to.
Why are you not able to just be calm and have a.
Miss Rose, it's fine. You think this is a joke. And if you're with corporate, how do you think this is okay?
How do you think this is
I'm
okay?
I'm an educated woman, and you're the two most pathetic things I have seen this year. It is true.
Wow. Are we not educated?
You don't act it.
Okay.
You are. You fooled me. I mean, I'm just saying. I've never been to a hotel and worked for a company and asked for a police escort. That could be your job.
We did not ask for a police escort.
Oh, but you're about
you're
to
throwing,
get one.
You're throwing
people.
you're throwing
you can't
at things
to a
that
hotel
happen.
Just because you work for a company and cause issues with other people.
We're not causing
who's,
any issues.
Who came to cause
but
issues?
But I came to cause an issue with you in corporate. You don't know who I am or what my credentials
and
are.
And you have no idea who I am
care
or what
less
my credentials
are.
Are.
The way you act. If you were nobody,
okay.
would be in my circle.
That's horrible.
I mean, get
that,
it.
That doesn't matter.
You've already made that clear that we people would not be in your circle.
Yes.
So we get that.
Right.
No, because you're corporate, remember? You're above the people here because we're incompetent. Right?
Stop calling over here.
Why?
Hold on. But why is it that you're not able to go like this? She came and she spoke with you. I apologize that I wasn't the person to speak to you.
That. Thank
so
you.
Then I come over here and I say, I'd like to, which is why I left her there. I said, you had an issue. Let me deal with my own.
I have an issue.
No. I was talking to my sister. I told my sister. I said you had an issue.
Your issues are not my hotel's problems. You people act crazy. That is what I'm.
Act crazy.
But well, yeah, well, when did I act crazy?
Take it to the house. Take it
Rose, when did I act crazy?
No, that is racist.
But when
that's
did I act crazy?
Be racist.
Tell the cop that when he gets here. I'll let y'all explain why you won't leave. You can just
but
tell
me
you're great.
But when did I act crazy?
We don't care. Oh my God.
When I stepped here, you already went off on me. What I need to do is to be here where I...
Oh, the cop is here. Sir, could you please ask these two ladies to leave, which we have tried to do for the past hour. The checkout is 11. We've asked them kindly to remove their belongings and leave my property. They've caught it. And,
sir,
and you see they're still
standing. If y'all don't mind, will y'all just...
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's crazy, bro. Still to this day. It's still here. Public Freakouts compilation number 364. If you enjoyed that video, comment, subscribe, share. Do all that other stuff.